Good morning, Malcolm Nance. In the 2 minutes a day you are not on television, hello, good morning.
Yeah, good morning. Crazy week.
Yeah, I'll say. Good God. Boy, where do we start? Let's start with Trump-Russia, just because it's always my favorite place to start. It is hard to underestimate, not just Manafort and Gates, but Papadopoulos, isn't it, and what's happened this week?
Oh, yes. I tell you, I had a hard time not calling you on Monday and Tuesday.
Oh, please call me anytime.
I'm telling you, it's just while I was neck deep in analyzing this. You know, what I love about the Mueller investigation is they went to the top of the chain of command, pretty much close to the top, and then to the absolute bottom of the chain of command. And by indicting everyone and indicting, you know, Manafort, Gates, and then Papadopoulos, and Papadopoulos had been turned months ago, everyone in between knows that their head is on the chopping block.
Yeah.
Everybody.
Yeah,
and,
well, if the Vanity Fair piece is to be believed, absolutely.
No, yeah. I mean, there's just no way. You know, and the funny thing is, I knew Manafort would be the first to be pinched because he was told when they raided his house last July, you're most likely going to be indicted. And, of course, they did that to bait him, to get him to see what he would do.
Right.
And he obviously, you know, obviously jumped the wrong way. And that they got his deputy, Rick Gates, who was a hard loyalist to him. And it's interesting because Trump does not like Rick Gates. But he was on the inauguration committee. And, you know, now there's no aspect of Manafort's life that isn't known business-wise. So Manafort's done. But the question here is, was Manafort the coordinator or the approval authority for all of the other dirty tricks? Including Michael Cohen, who sent the email in November 2015, essentially saying that he had been in contact with the Russians and that Putin was on his side and that Donald Trump would be elected president. Jared Kushner and Donald Trump Jr., who coordinated the meeting to go meet the Russian lawyer, Veselnitskaya, to essentially retrieve information, dirty tricks information about Hillary Clinton. And all of the other numerous teams who were out there. And then we're finding out Papadopoulos was running his own operation in which he was reporting up the chain of command. Yesterday, Corey Lewandowski was on Meet the Press Daily, MSNBC, and he just said flat out he has nothing to do with it. He had better pray to God that that statement is true because they have the goods now. And if email chains went to him and he replied or forwarded them in any way, he himself is done. This is starting to encompass everyone below Donald Trump.
Yeah. Tell us about this Sam Clovis. So he's suddenly gotten ensnared in this as well, right?
Well, Sam Clovis may have been one of the people that Papadopoulos was reporting into in the chain of command. And, you know, again, it's beautiful. If you look at the way that these prosecutors are going after it,
right,
everybody up and down. And then when you've got a low, you know, a flunky like Papadopoulos, who everyone is swearing they have never met, they have never heard from him, he never had anything to do with the campaign except serve coffee, even though he's sitting between the Attorney General and Donald Trump meeting, that they, you know, claim never had. Sam Clovis, Corey Lewandowski, and others were people Papadopoulos was corresponding with. But as I said, this is just the beginning of this. This will place pressure on everyone to start running into the Mueller's office and cutting deals.
Wow. You have said before that you think Flynn likely has already flipped.
Well, yeah, I think we said that months ago. It was like in February, March, that Flynn, you know, well, I know when we had that discussion in early July where we said who was going to get raided first. I said, if it's not Flynn, that means Flynn is flipped. Whoever is not cooperating gets a SWAT raid in the face. And it turned out to have been Manafort. Because Manafort is the most to lose. I think they've already clearly gotten to Flynn and explained that whatever distinguished career he had in the military is now finished. And all you can do is cooperate with us, and let's get this thing moving. And you know what would be in Flynn's interest? Drop it all on Manafort. Say, look, I was dirty, but Manafort's dirtier. And so we're going to find out. Now, interestingly enough, what if we find out that Manafort had flipped earlier than Papadopoulos, which was July 25th, and, you know, was wearing a wire?
Oh, boy. This is getting betterer and betterer.
With Donald Trump and his staff, you know?
Yeah.
When they were hinting that he would be pardoned. So this is going to be the best movie ever.
I
think Matt Damon and Leonardo DiCaprio are going to have to be tapped for major roles.
Who would you like to play you, Malcolm?
Oh, of course. You got to get Morgan Freeman.
Morgan Freeman, of course. Yes.
Denzel?
Of course. Malcolm, yeah, this is, it is sort of stunning. So he gives this, he calls the New York Times, right, to say, oh, I'm very calm. I'm not mad at anybody. As you know, I'm not a target. Do we know that he's not a target of the investigation?
Well, if you ask General Kelly. General Kelly said yesterday, this is hard to run a government when you're under investigation, you know, when the president's under investigation.
Right.
You know, this is, you've got to be absolutely out of your mind or, a hardcore Trump supporter to believe that he is not the goal. This is mafia Don, operations that are going on here.
Right. Anyone that's watched any crime movie ever knows that they go after the small fish first to get to the big fish, right?
Yeah, it's Goodfellas. So, the end of Goodfellas, where they flip the guy, or Sopranos, they're going after the top. And the way that they're going after the top is they go after the hardest nut of the crew. And that was Manafort. Manafort had a lot to lose. They only indicted him on $12 million. They estimate there was $80 million.
Wow.
But he managed to, illegitimately repatriate $12 million, making insane purchases like $849,000 in clothes. And he would, every time he would want to buy a pizza, he would call the pizzeria and have them accept a wire transfer from Cyprus.
God. He's the shadiest MF-er ever. I mean, really. Yeah, Malcolm, well, anyway, what is your take? I know a lot of people have said, I don't even know if Mueller's done this week. What do you think?
Here's the beautiful part. How many times on Monday did you hear the phrase, early in this investigation?
Yeah.
I don't know, maybe 200 times.
Yeah.
They were thinking, I think a lot of people thought it was going to be low-level people. And that's why they were saying, well, early in the investigation, you get low-level people to flip. Well, early in the investigation, we have one of the top three characters who are in the senior, top four characters who are in the senior command level below Trump. So if this is what early in the investigation looks like, the rest of this investigation is going to be historic. And no matter what you say, we already are the seated Watergate, because Watergate was about malfeasance of the president, carrying out political actions. This is the first step to finding out through, intelligence methodologies that these people may have been wholly owned subsidiary of the Kremlin. And as I said the other day on radio, I said it's quite possible that this is the greatest intelligence operation in history, in which one country has taken control or put into leadership the presidency of another country that has atomic bombs.
Yeah. It is stunning and just vomit-inducing. Malcolm, let's talk about, obviously, as a terrorism expert and intelligence analyst, this thing in New York. I mean, first of all, it is hard to underestimate how badly Donald Trump will mishandle anything. But, I mean, starting from blaming Chuck Schumer to now him blabbing on Twitter about, David Frum tweeted, attempting to dictate the outcome and sentence of a criminal trial is about as bad an abuse of presidential power as can be imagined.
The guy may get off. The guy may miss the death penalty now.
Yeah.
Because the president has ruled in and essentially, he did that with Bo Bergdahl, the prisoner of war. He essentially ruled in and made a fiat that could undermine the entire prosecution. I mean, I'm in New York right now. I've been at the crash site all week. Since it occurred. And let me tell you something. We prosecute terrorists in this city all the time.
Right.
So many pro-ISIS people and the rest that you don't even hear about them except in these big cases.
Yeah.
And, if you send them to Guantanamo Bay, as we saw this morning, Trump figured out that there's people down there who have been on trial for 17 years.
17, yep, exactly. Yeah. I mean, I, as a real tough guy, it must just kill you, these fake tough guys, just because he knows it'll sound tough to say, send them to Gitmo, right? But it just, yeah.
It's that political. And what's even worse is it undermines all of our counterterrorism operations.
Yeah.
And brings out all the bigots and all the racists and, you know, all the posers who want to, you know, go into war tomorrow. How much more war can you take?
Yeah.
I mean, we've only been fighting nonstop. I just heard this yesterday. You know, somebody saying, well, we've got to really take it to them now.
Yeah.
Well, how much more taking it to them can we put out? I mean,
yeah.
You know, what do you do?
Malcolm, I don't know whether I'm being a squishy liberal, but isn't that making him a martyr? The death penalty, isn't that what they want? I mean, he expected to die in this attack, I assume, right?
We pretty much are sending all these guys to the supermax out in Colorado, and they disappear from history. I mean, there's terrorists in there that I spent years helping track down. Most notably, the first World Trade Center bomber who was holed up in Pakistan. And have you heard from him?
Yeah. Yeah.
No. Got convicted in the late 90s.
Yeah.
Black hole, gone from history. And, you know, there may be a side note on Wikipedia the day he died, but that's pretty much it.
Yep, absolutely. Malcolm, real quick before you go, everybody's digesting this new Donna Brazile stuff. The headline, Donna Brazile, I found proof Hillary rigged the race against Bernie. Of course, she's selling a book. I mean, I hate to be conspiratorial, but I'm going, oh, well, is she working for Russia now? Like, what is going on?
She's not working for Russia. I'm afraid to say she might be working for herself.
Yeah.
If I see her, I'll ask her, because I'll tell you, I read the whole story. I don't see where the Democratic Party rigged the election.
I know. I know.
I mean, all they're saying is something every person knew. We knew about it when Russia released the email.
Yeah.
Of the DNC, that Debbie Wasserman Schultz was in the tank for Hillary Clinton. Tell us something we didn't know.
Right.
That the Clinton campaign was paying the debt, that the Obama campaign was paying the debt of the DNC off to make them work in the face of this election. Where's the beef here? And what's the intent? Is she trying to go back to July 25th, 2016 and say that Bernie was robbed? What does that book do? It splits the Democratic Party in half. Mm-hmm. It gives Trump 8 years in office.
Yep. Yep. Yeah, absolutely. I just said, and we're this close, right, to Mueller time, to impeachment time. I'm like, really? I mean,
was the foreword of her book done by Captain Obvious?
Malcolm, great stuff. We'll see you next week, honey. Thank you.
Right.
Or call me anytime, please. Don't resist.
Yeah,
don't resist if you feel the urge.
I'll be in the Middle East next week, so you'll get a fun call from me there.
From where?
The Middle East.
Oh, the Middle East. All right. Thank you. All right. Talk to you next week. There he goes. Malcolm Nance. Please, don't resist the urge. Call me anytime.
I like that.